Thank you. The final item of business is a member's business debate on motion 10262 in the name of Rona Mackay on opening of Scotland's first Bairns Hoose. This debate will be concluded without any questions being put, and I would ask those members who would wish to speak in the debate to please press the request to speak buttons, and I call on Rona Mackay to open the debate. Around 7 minutes, please.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. Members' debates often highlight crisis or serious issues which generate political division and rancour. That's why I'm overjoyed and honoured to bring such a genuine good news story to the Chamber, one of which Scotland's government and partner organisations can be very proud. The opening of Scotland's first Bairns Hoose last month means that at last we can reform how children and young people are treated by the justice system in Scotland. It's an enormous and joyous achievement and marks a whole new way of supporting young people who find themselves in our justice system traditionally designed for and by adults. That's because the Bairns Hoose has been designed in collaboration with children and young people for children and young people and includes calming wall colours, soft and comfortable furnishings and a safe and secure garden which will offer breathing space for those who need it. But before I go on to describe more about the background to the birth of the Bairns Hoose in Scotland, I'd like you to hear this quote from Jasmine, now aged 18, visiting Scotland's first Bairns Hoose in North Strathclyde. When I went to court, I had to sit in an empty box room with no windows, no sweets or anything, and a few broken toys. I was 9 years old. If you're coming from dealing with something terrible, you don't want to come somewhere broken when you already feel broken. It's good to know kids can come to the Bairns Hoose and it's a safe place. Presiding Officer, there are so many people to thank for making this innovative project a reality. Huge congratulations must go to Children First and the many third sector organisations who led the way in this fantastic initiative in conjunction with the Scottish Government. They were supported by Victim Support Scotland, University of Edinburgh, Children England and £1.5 million from the Postcode Dream Fund, which is made possible, of course, by the players of the People's Postcode Lottery. In the last Parliament, the former Justice Committee, of which I was and still am a member of the present one, travelled to Norway to visit the Bairns Hoose there. Presiding Officer, it's safe to say that all members were blown away by what we witnessed. This was a world away from an intimidating courtroom full of scary adults and old stuff. All the care and support a child and their family needs is delivered under one roof in a welcoming and safe environment. Legal and medical professionals come to them, not the other way around. And I'm delighted to say that the first Bairns Hoose will support children, young people and members of their family from my own local authority area of Eastern Bartonshire, as well as East Renfrewshire, Inverclyde and Renfrewshire. On November the 1st this year, the Bairns Hoose in Iceland will celebrate its 25th anniversary. Children First supported a delegation from Scotland to visit Iceland in 2017, which directly led to this Hoose opening and the work of the European Promise Network, which is a network that connects European practice to develop and commit to the Bairns Hoose quality standards. So for context, in the past year, the Children First Bairns Hoose recovery team have supported 104 children in 90 families going through the child protection and justice system in North Strathclyde. Now the Hoose is open, it will be used as the new centre for this work. Young people who experience abuse and violence will be able to get all the protection, care, justice and recovery support they need under one roof. And crucially, they can avoid the need to repeatedly share their story over and over. At the moment, children who experience hurt and harm are processed through a complex system of care and justice and are asked to retell and relive traumatic experiences over and over, sometimes up to 14 times. That whole process creates standalone trauma. Presiding Officer, we can't always stop bad things happening to children and young people, but we can do everything in our power to help them recover and heal. So why do we need a Bairns Hoose? Because it's a place where children and young people are interviewed and medically examined for forensic purposes, assessed and receive recovery services from the right people all in one place. It's a trauma-informed space designed to reduce feelings of anxiousness, fear and a lack of support and control that are so often associated with victims and witnesses' experience of the justice system. And sadly, the scale of harm children and young people in Scotland experience is significant. At least 37 of the 14,602 sexual crimes recorded in 22-23 by police related to a victim under the age of 18. Exhausting delays in cases mean that fear and anticipation surrounding going to court can last years, and repeated adjournments mean that anxiety and stress build repeatedly up to a court date. Children and families tell us that court buildings feel unsafe and untrustworthy. Giving evidence in court can be brutal for adults. Just imagine what it's like for a child. One of the major aims of the Bairns Hoose is to support the gathering of high-quality pre-recorded evidence that can be used in court so that the number of times children have to tell their story can be reduced as far as possible. So it has advanced technical facilities, including space to record evidence and to deliver live links to court. The high-quality setup should remove the need for children to attend court at all, which of course would be the aim. Presiding Officer, children and young people have the right to recovery. Article 39 of the UNCRC states that children have this right. However, this part often gets lost in child protection and justice processes that have been traditional. The Scottish Government committed in the Programme for Government to launch Pathfinders this autumn, which will support new work and partnerships to develop among agencies. And there's a strong commitment across police, justice, health, social work and the third sector leaders to deliver this transformation, which will realise children's rights to justice and recovery. But we must ensure children have this option to pre-record or live link to the court. So the launch of the Bairns Hoose is not just an event, it's a promise that we will treat children and young people who've been abused and traumatised with the respect and dignity they deserve. And in conclusion, Presiding Officer, let's remember the words of Nelson Mandela. There can be no keener revelation of a society's soul than the way in which it treats its children. So I offer my congratulations to all those who've worked so hard to make this possible. Together, let's continue to nurture and protect our most precious asset, our children. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Mackay. I now call Audrey Nicholl to be followed by Ros McCall. Ms. McNicholl.
Thank you very much. And I'd first of all like to thank Rona Mackay for bringing this very timeliest members' debate forward and for highlighting the establishment of the first Bairns Hoose in Scotland, located in North Strathclyde. And I think we could almost feel Rona Mackay's sense of sheer delight in her opening remarks, and rightly so. The implementation of Scotland's first Bairns Hoose is very, very welcome, and I know will support and benefit the children and families who may one day use its services. And as already highlighted, Bairns Hoose seeks to protect children who come into contact with the criminal justice system after they have experienced, participated in, or witnessed significantly harmful behaviour. And through minimising a child's engagement with the courts and by creating a more welcoming and therapeutic environment with access to specialist services, children are supported to better recover from the traumatic events that they have endured. And indeed, Iceland's Bairns Hoose model, the model that Bairns Hoose is based on, consistently demonstrates positive outcomes, including less risk of a child becoming re-traumatised from having to recount their experiences. The Bairns Hoose environment is far more favourable than that of a police station or a court, and the model has seen an improvement in the conviction rate for sexual abuse or child sexual abuse cases. And there are many ways in which children can enter the justice system, perhaps through civil proceedings such as adoption, or even through matters of immigration. And each case can be difficult for a child to navigate. And while these cases can be harmful for children, there are none that place a child more at risk than that of violence and abuse. So in a modern day justice environment, the Bairns Hoose model has a very important role to play. Reflecting on my own experience as an investigator of serious and complex sexual crimes, some involving children, progress has very much been made. And I recall how excited we were when Grampian Police decorated a room on the fourth floor of police headquarters. We put a sofa in and soft lighting and a box of toys. And we were really proud that we felt that this was a first step towards a multi-agency response to child sexual offences. And I recently found a copy of a report that I co-wrote as part of a review of child protection services within Grampian Police back in 2006, and I was slightly bemused to read, and I quote, "The concept of joint working should be borne in mind during any future expansion of family protection services, thus enabling partners to co-locate alongside police. This could be as simple as factoring in some spare office accommodation and car parking facilities." Well, I'm very glad to say that progress, and a lot of progress, has been made since then. Members will be aware Scotland's approach to investigating allegations of child sexual abuse has more recently been informed by Lady Dorrian's report on the management of sexual offences, and the Bairns Hoose model aligns with the recommendations outlined in the report, which highlights the importance of improving the experiences of children in the justice system. And I'm pleased the programme for government includes the launch of a Bairns Hoose Pathfinder, as Rona Mackay referenced, as part of the work to develop a whole system approach for children experiencing abuse and harm. And of course, the Victims, Witnesses and Justice Reform Bill will see further reform to improve the experiences of children coming into the criminal justice system. So in closing, I very much look forward to following the progress of the newly opened Bairns Hoose and to the model being further developed across Scotland in line with our commitment to improve the experiences of children coming into the system. And my thanks again to Rona Mackay for bringing this important topic to the Chamber, and I look forward to listening to other members' contributions.
Thank you, Ms Nicholl. I now call Ros McCall to be followed by Katie Clark. Ms McCall.
Thank you, Deputy Presiding Officer. I welcome this motion, and I thank Rona Mackay for bringing it to the Chamber this evening. Thank you. The opening of Scotland's first Bairns Hoose is indeed a very welcome addition to the judicial process, and I sincerely hope we will see more of them open all over Scotland. I want to take a quick moment to mention Children First, Victim Support Scotland, the University of Edinburgh, Children England, and for all the participants of the Postcode Lottery for their backing and for the help to make this dream of a secure and safe place for children, young people and families become a reality. In what is the most traumatic of experiences, during the most distressing and disturbing of times, a calming and safe environment with children and young people at its heart is indeed a great step forward. Imagine you're a mum sitting in the gallery of a courtroom watching your daughter recount the harrowing and disturbing events that took place over 2.5 years ago when she was 17. It's been with her every day of the 2.5 years while she waits for the case to come to trial. It's the fourth date she's been given by the courts, but there's always some reason for the trial to be postponed, prolonging her anxiety and adding to her torment. You know she's had to recount this story again and again and again over the years, in back rooms of police stations and in council offices. And with the best will in the world, these rooms are gloomy, oppressive, and sparse, where the grey of her emotions blend with the feelings in the room. You also know she feels humiliated, disgusted with herself, and shamed that she is once again forced to relive the events of that night. What was forced on her? What she should now do differently if she could only go back? And how she must now own up to what society has made her feel is, at least, partially her fault. You know she will have to stand there whilst the defence indicates the events did not happen, implying to everyone that she is a liar and that you know the chances of justice will be served is slim at best. You watch your usually strong, self-assured, beautiful daughter start to flick the hairband on her wrist, a nervous twitch from when she was a child, and then she crumbles and breaks down on the stand, and there is absolutely nothing you can do to help her. She is standing not more than a few feet away from the accused, and the screen is doing nothing more than blocking a view. But you can see from her actions that it's not minimising the effect of the person in the room. As a parent, you'd do anything to make this better. If only every step of the process was just made that little bit better. That is why facilities like Bairns Hoose are so important. Being able to use a safe space to give evidence, knowing that the process is as good as it can possibly be under the circumstances, and providing a secure foundation towards recovery and moving on with a positive life must be the goal. But secure accommodation is only part of it, and we in this place must assure that additional support for victims and witnesses are included in all processes moving forward if that goal is to be achieved. I sincerely hope that this is the start, not only for more Bairns Hooses across Scotland, but for a proper shift in the way our judicial system views its victims, especially young and vulnerable witnesses, because that's the only way the scales of justice will be rebalanced. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. McCall. I now call Katie Clark to be followed by Liam MacArthur. Ms. Clark.
Thank you, Presiding Officer, and I congratulate Rona Mackay on securing this important debate and warmly welcome her initiative, which has led to this issue being debated in the Chamber today. I also want to place on record my thanks to Victim Support Scotland, Children First and the other organisations who have been involved in the opening of Scotland's first Bairns Hoose. As Rona Mackay has already said, Bairns Hoose is based on Iceland's renowned model and seeks to bring the needs of child victims and witnesses together with justice, health, social work and recovery support at a single point of contact. As an MSP for West Scotland Region, I, like Rona Mackay, am very pleased that the first Bairns Hoose will be supporting child victims and witnesses in Eastern Bartonshire, East Renfrewshire, Inverclyde and Renfrewshire. It's important that all eligible children are able to access such facilities so that they can get the trauma-informed support that this model provides. I look forward to hearing how the Bairns Hoose develops and its effect on outcomes. I would be grateful if the Minister was able to provide an update today and commit to future parliamentary updates on the progress being made towards widening access to Bairns Hoose to eligible children across Scotland and indeed other initiatives that enable child victims and witnesses to get access to trauma-informed practices. Ahead of today's debate, Victim Support Scotland reiterated its concerns that some local authorities may choose to use Bairns Hoose as a place of safety for a child who has caused harm. If that was the case, potentially this could increase the risk of re-traumatising victims and witnesses, including child victims, undermining the very purpose of Bairns Hoose as a service. So therefore, I would be grateful if the Minister could respond to the concerns being raised and address why Victim Support Scotland are calling for the Scottish Government to guarantee that no Bairns Hoose in Scotland will be used as a place of safety under the Age of Criminal Responsibility Scotland Act 2019. And I hope that the Minister will give the guarantee today and perhaps outline how the Scottish Government will establish trauma-informed needs and support service required for children who have caused harm, but also ensure that the needs of others, other victims, have their rights addressed. Bairns Hoose is a key part of improving the experiences of child victims and witnesses in Scotland's justice system, but I think we all recognise it is not the sole solution to the problem. That's why many stakeholders have raised concerns about the proposed Children, Care and Justice Bill currently being scrutinised by Parliament. The concern is that this bill provides a lack of provision which ensures support and information is in place for victims who've been harmed by children, and that potentially it creates an imbalance between the rights of the child who has caused harm over that of the child victim. There are also issues with the bill in terms of the lack of information sharing provisions and lack of safety planning and risk management measures. As the Minister will know, a number of stakeholders, including Victim Support Scotland, Rape Crisis Scotland and Women's Aid, have come together to suggest a number of changes which could be made to the bill. So, in responding to the debate today, I would urge the Scottish Government to seriously consider what is being said and ensure that legislation going forward truly delivers an improved experience for child victims and witnesses in Scotland. Bairns Hoose alone will not transform the experience of all child victims and witnesses in Scotland, but it is a very important development, which I very much warmly welcome. So for that reason, I associate myself with Rona Mackay and indeed all the other members who have spoken in this debate and congratulate again all those who have been involved in opening Scotland's first Bairns Hoose.
Thank you, Ms Clark. I now call Liam MacArthur to be followed by Bill Kidd. Mr MacArthur.
Thank you, President Officer. Can I start by congratulating Rose McCall on what I thought was a hugely, profoundly moving contribution? I think it illustrates that this is a debate that comes from a dark place, but hopefully, as Ronan Mackay indicated, it provides some cause for optimism that we're moving in the right direction. Can I also pay tribute to my good friend Ronan Mackay for her personal efforts, both in securing this debate, but on this particular issue. She and I were members of the Justice Committee in the last session. I like to think that we played our part in making strides to where we are today, in highlighting the benefits of the Barnahus model, and in building the evidence base for that, and making the compelling case to government. I think she referred to the trip the committee made to Norway to see firsthand Barnahus in practice, and I think that had a very profound effect on all of us, and I think developed the cross-party commitment to apply what pressure we could on the government to go forward and deliver. And I think there may be a perception now that we were pushing against an open door, but I know there were concerns at that stage about how transferable that joined up multidisciplinary approach across child protection, justice, health, recovery service could be in a Scottish context. And I think Audrey Nicholl spoke to that from her own personal experience. But I think there was absolutely no doubt that while the needs of the Scottish context needed to be taken into account, there was absolutely no doubt that this was a model that could be rolled out in Scotland. There was reference made previously to the Dorian review. Let me put on record my gratitude to Lord Carloway for the earlier review undertaken in 2013, which I think again paved the way, making the argument, and I quote, that taking the evidence of young and vulnerable witnesses requires special care, and that subjecting them to the traditional adversarial form of examination and cross-examination is no longer acceptable. I think that is now the received wisdom, and we are in a different place 10 years on. We've seen the Victim and Witnesses Act in 2014 and the pre-recording and other protections put in place, but I think we can't be complacent. The Edinburgh University report in relation to the first stage of the current project indicated that children are still being asked to go to court in almost all cases, and I think that's a real concern. Moving away from court-based evidence is going to require a culture shift. It will need people to change habits and trust new processes, and I think there was strong support in the Justice Committee in the last session for that, and I have no doubt that Rona Mackay and her colleagues will be equally supportive of that going forward. In the past, as I've said, there can be no justice in a system where victims report that their experiences of that system are actually worse than the crime itself. For children and young victims, telling and retelling what has happened to them over and over and over again simply re-traumatises. Doing this in environments that are inappropriate, unfriendly and even adversarial makes this many times worse, further harming rather than healing. So I'm delighted this project's been taken forward in North Strathclyde. Join others in congratulating Children First, Victim Support Scotland, Edinburgh University, Children England, and give thanks to Postcode Lottery for the funding enabling this to happen. It's an approach that puts the needs and rights of children and young people at the centre of child protection and justice processes. And as Children First acknowledge, while it isn't always possible to stop bad things happening, we should be moving mountains to help children and young victims to recover. I recognise we're probably a long way away from achieving the complete rollout by 2025. I know Victim Support Scotland referred to that in their briefing. It's perhaps maybe another example of where the government needs to be careful in not underestimating the complexities and not over-promising what can be delivered. But I think the model we're seeing and the rollout of that so that we learn as we go is absolutely the right one. But we want to see this rolled out more widely. I'm keen in particular to see progress made in identifying how this might be made to work in our island communities, for example. The visit to Norway demonstrated different approaches in urban and rural areas are often needed. The needs of children and young people aren't perhaps different, but the way in which those needs are met almost certainly will look and feel slightly different. So I would be grateful if the Minister might be able, in winding up, to indicate when we might expect those sorts of developments in island and rural communities to take place. But for now, I congratulate Rona Mackay once again, congratulate all the partners involved in this and wish them the very, very best of luck. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms MacArthur. I now call Bill Kidd to be followed by John Swinney. Mr Kidd.
Thank you very much, Presiding Officer. And may I also take the opportunity, as others quite rightly have, to commend Rona Mackay on securing today's debate. I'd also like to thank all of those involved in the development of Scotland's first Bairns Hoose, as mentioned in today's motion, alongside the support of the Scottish Government and its commitment to ensuring this transformational approach to child welfare is rolled out nationally. The vision is for all children in Scotland to have been victims of or witnesses to abuse or violence, as well as children under the age of criminal responsibility whose behaviour has maybe caused significant harm or abuse, to have access to trauma-informed recovery, support and justice. The need for such a service is evident when we consider that of the over 14,000 incidents of recorded sexual crimes in 2022-23, over a third related to a victim under the age of 18. It's been pointed out that at the moment, children who experience hurt and harm can sometimes be processed through what can be seen as a complex system of care and justice in which they can be asked to retell or relive traumatic experiences many times over. One of the stated aims of the Bairns Hoose model would be to prevent children being re-traumatised and to improve the experience of the justice process for children and families. And one of the ways that many stakeholders believe this can be achieved is through Bairns Hoose's becoming a one-stop location for the number of services needed to support a victim's journey. The Scottish Government's literature echoes this possibility, stating that a key element of Bairns Hoose is the provision of a child-friendly setting which supports an integrated approach as part of the team around the child, bringing together services in a four rooms approach with child protection, health, justice and recovery services all available in one setting in line with the Getting It Right for Every Child practice model and national guidance for child protection in Scotland. As a member of the Education, Children and Young People Committee, I welcome these aims, and in evidence sessions on the Children, Care and Justice Scotland Bill at Stage 1 and in discussions I have subsequently had with stakeholders, the Bairns Hoose model has been held up as a model which could address some of the concerns organisations have regarding over-complexity within the system and a need for more efficient information sharing. In its Stage 1 report, the committee reflected these points, recognising the government's commitment to roll out the Bairns Hoose model for all child victims and witnesses of violence. However, it went on to note that stakeholders are unclear as yet as to how this bill will align with the Bairns Hoose model rollout and asked the Scottish Government to clarify how these measures will work together. And whilst I appreciate that we are at a very early stages of the Government's Pathfinder delivery plan and full rollout scheduled from 2027, I would ask the Minister to also reflect upon how the model can be integrated into legislation currently going through Parliament to address any concerns, unleash the full potential of the Bairns Hoose model and ensure that it is truly transformational. And I know that we can trust the Scottish Government to follow up on this. And thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr Kidd. And I now call John Swinney. Mr Swinney.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I congratulate my colleague Rona Mackay on securing this debate, which provides Parliament with the opportunity to reflect on the significant moment that has been reached with the establishment of the first Bairns Hoose in Scotland. And I think Rona Mackay's personal, undiluted enthusiasm for this has been demonstrated so powerfully in the debate today, as has that point been reflected in the contributions of colleagues across the parliamentary chamber. This is a moment that's been reached due to the tenacity of many campaigners who've been determined to ensure that when children face the most difficult of times that they should never, ever have had to face, they can be supported effectively in being able to address that suffering. The Bairns Hoose is being taken forward by a partnership led by Children First and involving Victim Support Scotland, the University of Edinburgh and Children England. Crucial funding has been provided by the People's Postcode Lottery of £1.5 million. In welcoming the participation of each partner, I hope others will forgive me if I single out the exceptional contribution of Children First in ensuring this milestone has been reached. From my ministerial experience, I vividly recall the energy and the commitment given by Children First to generate interest in and support for the concept of a Bairns Hoose. Modelled on the European Barnet House model, the Bairns Hoose means that children and young people who experience abuse and violence will be able to get all the protection, care, justice and recovery support they will need under one roof. This proposal will support children and young people in Eastern Bartonshire, in East Renfrewshire, Inverclyde and Renfrewshire. The reason why Children First have been so tenacious in taking this idea forward is for the simple reason that this proposal puts the child right at the heart of the approach. The model aims to avoid the current situation that means children can often have to recount their experiences on a number of occasions when it has been bad enough that they have had to experience the circumstances once. The aim of the model is to ensure all of the support that a child needs can be based around the child. It puts the child right at the centre of the process, assuring that the support is brought to the child rather than children having to join the dots of a compartmentalised adult design justice system. And how many constituents have we all supported in that particular position? The way in which this project has developed sets out an important lesson for us about how reforms can and should take place in our society. Although the Scottish Government has been a very supportive party in this endeavour, and I'm delighted the government has been so supportive, the initiative has rested with the third sector, principally through the work of Children First. The need for reform has been identified by the third sector and has been championed by the third sector. I do hope the Scottish Government and also Scotland's local authorities will recognise the absolute necessity to be open to this type of initiative and of creating the space to enable ventures of this type to thrive, and crucially, if I can say so quite bluntly, not getting in the way of these reforms into the bargain. There has to be space left for the initiative of the third sector to find a route through some of the obstacles and barriers that inevitably crop up in engaging with the public sector. And the Bairns Hoose is a spectacular example of that in practice. And I congratulate everyone who's played a part in making this happen.
Thank you, Mr. Swinney. And I now call on Minister Natalie Dawn to respond to the debate. Around 7 minutes, please, Minister.
Thank you very much, Presiding Officer. And I'd just like to thank Rona Mackay for lodging this very, very important motion and all members today for their contributions. I really welcome the opportunity to respond on behalf of the Scottish Government this afternoon. I'd like to begin by sharing our support for the motion and our recognition of the significance of this milestone. The opening of this facility in North Strathclyde is, I know, the culmination of many years of hard work from a range of partners, and I congratulate them on this fantastic achievement. Children in North Strathclyde who are the victims or witnesses of abuse or violence will, through this service, be able to access protection, care and recovery services under one roof. I'm aware that the Scottish Government funding for engagement work with children and young people with lived experience of child protection and justice systems, the Changemakers, has played a central role in the design of the facility, And as Ms Mackay describes in her motion and in her opening comments, it's led to the creation of a child-friendly, nurturing environment. And I want to thank Ms Mackay for her comments and her opening remarks, and I think the quote from Jasmine that she shared emphasises that this definitely is the right approach for children and young people in Scotland. So I'd like to put on record my thanks to all those children and young people involved in that, and I look forward to visiting the site myself in the coming weeks to see the fruits of their commitment. Bringing the Barnahus model to Scotland has been a long-standing, cross-cutting policy ambition for a number of years, and one which Children First has long championed. Several years ago, they organised, as members have referred to today, they organised a study visit to see the Barnahus in Iceland, which included my predecessor and colleague Mr Matheson, who was then Justice Secretary. Since then, engagement with partners across agencies and Scottish Government has built a compelling case for the need for Bairns Hoose in Scotland, and indeed Children First has been a key partner in the development of national Bairns Hoose standards and sits on the National Bairns Hoose Governance Group. Now, our vision for Bairns Hoose is that all children in Scotland who have been victims or witnesses of abuse or violence, as well as children under the age of criminal responsibility whose behaviour has caused significant harm or abuse, will have access to trauma-informed recovery, support and justice. This scope of access is ambitious when we look at other European countries who have already adopted the model. And I want to assure the Chamber that a key consideration in the development of Bairns Hoose, which will be taken into account in the development of the policy, will be balancing the rights of victims and those of the children whose behaviour has caused harm. Bairns Hoose will build on the momentum of the new Scottish Child Interview Model for Joint Investigative Interviews, which is being introduced nationally from 2021 to 2024, and will be seen as the justice room of the Bairns Hoose. A key aim of the Scottish Child Interview Model, which has been supported by over £2 million funding from the Scottish Government, is to protect children and reduce stress when recounting their experiences. And I note John Swinney's comments on the difference this will make to the lives of children. And also, I thank Ros McCall for her moving contribution, while extremely difficult, served to remind us why settings like this are so important and the difference that the steps that we take now will make to the lives of victims of harm. Growing evidence is already showing the benefits of the new model in practice. For example, interviewers in the North East Scotland Partnership were able to use their specialist training to support a non-verbal child with complex needs to share details of their abusive experience for the first time. This new model for joint investigative interviews allows for partners to create bespoke plans for children's individual needs, resulting in improved experiences. There are many similar examples emerging of this momentous change in practice across Scotland. I know that Katie Clark wanted an update on progress, and I can give that now, and further to that, I'm happy to keep the Member and Parliament updated as this progresses. We've introduced a three-phased approach for the development of Bairns Hoose, which builds in the necessary stages for learning and evaluation to enable the achievement of our ambition. The first phase, the Pathfinder phase, commences this year and will lead into a pilot phase ahead of national rollout. The Pathfinders will show us how the recently published National Bairns Hoose Standards work in practice, enabling us to better understand and address the complexity of the necessary systemic change. Through the Pathfinders, we'll start to improve the experience of children, young people and their families in the justice, care and recovery services. In our programme for government announced last week, we committed to launching Bairns Hoose Pathfinders in autumn 2023, a key action in our Keeping the Promise implementation plan and Tackling Child Poverty delivery plan, enabling a whole system approach for child victims and witnesses of abuse and harm. And it is through that phased approach to implementation that we seek to capitalise on the enthusiasm to deliver this transformational change for children who have experienced trauma. And our commitment to the agenda is clear in our investment of £6 million in 2023-24 to establish those Pathfinder partnerships. And we expect a similar level of investment to support Pathfinders next year. Yes, thank you.
Liam MacArthur.
Can I thank the Minister for taking the intervention? I don't necessarily expect a detailed response now, but let me put it on the record. Obviously, in an island context, paediatric forensics requires children and young people to be taken off island for examination at present. So the rollout of any model in the islands is going to present additional challenges. Is there something in the way the Pathfinders have been taken forward that might be able to explore how that holistic approach can be taken in that island context?
Minister.
I maybe can't address the point directly, but I was about to come on to some of the concerns that you had raised during your comments. The assessment of applications to become Pathfinder partnerships is currently underway, and I'm looking forward to our announcement of those successful Pathfinders next month. I want to emphasise that we want Bairns Hoose to be adopted across Scotland, and will also engage with those areas that are not Pathfinders so that they can share in the learning and build towards making Bairns Hoose services available nationally. Now, in relation to the comments from Liam MacArthur, how this will work in rural areas will be considered, and we will be trialling Bairns Hoose standards in a range of different contexts. So these things will be assessed through the Pathfinder phase. I'd like to just in summing up, quote Bragi Gudbranson, member of the United Nations Committee on the Rights of the Child and founder of the Barna Hoose model, who said of Barna Hoose, "There is no other viable way to deal with child abuse, but that we need to be patient, meaning we need to be considered and get it right. Children and young people deserve this, and I think our phased approach does exactly that." Presiding Officer, I'd just like to close by reiterating the Scottish Government's wholehearted support for this motion, and thanks to the partners who have worked so hard to get to this point. I thank Rona Mackay for the motion and look forward to the parliamentary event on this topic in November, where we will continue our constructive dialogue. Bairns Hoose represents a significant step forward in improving our response for children who have experienced trauma, and we look forward to this next phase where we will work together to build on this momentum for them. Thank you.
Thank you, Minister. That concludes the debate, and I close this meeting.